Diabetes is a serious health condition that can affect anyone. In fact, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, 122 million Americans are living with diabetes or prediabetes, and most are unaware that they have it. So, what exactly is diabetes? There are a few different types, but they all have to do with how your body uses blood sugar. When we eat food, most of it is broken down into sugars and released into our bloodstream. This is what's called our blood sugar or blood glucose. Insulin, which is made by the pancreas, acts like a key, helping to get glucose into your body's cells to be used for energy. When you have diabetes, your body either makes little or no insulin or does not use it correctly. Glucose then stays in your blood and doesn't get into your cells the way it should. The four most common types of diabetes are type 1, prediabetes, type 2, and gestational. Type 1, also known as juvenile diabetes, is a chronic condition where the body produces little or no insulin. This can be caused by genetics or viruses and typically develops during childhood. It can be diagnosed in adults, though usually before the age of 40. Type 1 must be managed with insulin injections, a closely monitored diet, and exercise. Prediabetes is when your blood sugar levels are higher than normal, but not high enough to be diagnosed as diabetes. A prediabetes diagnosis is a major risk factor for developing type 2 diabetes. Type 2 is when your cells become resistant to insulin. So instead of glucose going into your cells to be used for energy, they stay in your bloodstream, causing high blood glucose levels and, as a result, an onset of health problems. Type 2 is the most common form of diabetes in adults age 45 and older, making up 90% of all diabetes diagnoses. Gestational diabetes can occur during pregnancy, affecting many important women in our lives, such as our daughters, granddaughters, caregivers, and friends. In many cases, women have no symptoms. An expectant mother might not even know she's at risk until she is tested and diagnosed by her doctor. Gestational diabetes does go away after birth, but it can affect the baby's health and increase the mother's risk of developing type 2 later in life. While type 1 is genetic, prediabetes, type 2, and gestational are not. There are a number of risk factors that increase your chances of developing these types of diabetes. Some of these factors we can't control, such as age, family history, and giving birth to a baby who weighs more than 9 pounds. Ethnic background is also a factor. African Americans, Hispanics, Latino Americans, and Native Americans are all at higher risk. Symptoms are often subtle and can even go unnoticed. These include feeling the need to urinate more than usual, being very thirsty throughout the day, craving food and feeling hungrier than normal, and losing weight without changing your diet. Although these symptoms can be less obvious, it's important to discuss them with your doctor as soon as possible. Diabetes can be diagnosed by a simple blood test. Even if you don't experience symptoms, it's recommended that people age 45 and older be screened for type 2 every 3 years. Diabetes can lead to major health risks if left undiagnosed or not treated correctly. Some of these risks include vision disorders, disease of the blood vessels, heart disease, and stroke. Other serious risks include nerve complications, kidney problems, and the potential loss or use of fingers, toes, or other body parts. The good news is prediabetes, type 2, and gestational diabetes are, for the most part, preventable and even reversible with healthy lifestyle choices. Those are not smoking, making healthy food choices, getting regular exercise, and maintaining a healthy weight. Smokers are 50% more likely to develop diabetes than those who don't smoke. Heavy smokers have an even higher risk. When it comes to food choices, follow the recommendations of your doctor or a registered dietitian. Sometimes diabetes can be complicated by other illnesses that require a special type of diet. You'll want to fill your plate with whole grains, fruits, vegetables, nuts, and beans, and consider healthier proteins such as fish, poultry, or tofu. Skip highly processed foods and sugary drinks. Even just one can of soda has more sugar in it than the suggested daily allowance. Try swapping sugary drinks for sparkling water or another type of decaffeinated beverage. That one change alone can make a big difference. Any type of physical activity that works your muscles helps them use insulin and absorb glucose. The more you move, the better. It doesn't have to be intense exercise either. Light activities such as daily walks and stretching can have a positive impact. And staying in a healthy weight range is also important. If you are overweight, losing even just 5 to 10% of your total weight can significantly help lower your risk of developing diabetes. Remember, it's never too late to start making healthy lifestyle choices so you can lower your risk. Thank you for your time. We hope this information was helpful and that you have a better understanding of diabetes. Please visit CignaHealthierTogether.com for more videos in our Healthier Together series.